What's going on, guys? This is Sim with Vengeance, and I am back here with another NCAA Football 14 Dynasty featuring the UAB Blazers. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take on the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. And it looks like Kirk Herbstreit's got us winning again. But here's the thing. We lost a tough game last week to a very good Washington State offense. And now we need to bounce back. We've lost two in a row. We just gotta find a way. We see our tough loss last week, and then we got our butts handed to us against wow, we were playing like three days. Wow, two games in 3 days. We are tired, but a very bad loss to LSU, and of course we had that one lone loss in week one against Iowa State. But we're gonna take a look at the top 25 real quick, to give you guys like a little rundown of what's going on. Texas A&M at 4-0 at number 1, Stanford at number 2, Alabama 3, Florida 4, Louisville 5, Georgia 6, Oklahoma 7, Ohio State 8, Texas 9, Oregon 10, Clemson 11, Notre Dame, South Carolina, Michigan, and UCLA going out from 11 to 15, 16 and through 20 we have Nebraska, Florida State, LSU, Washington, and Michigan State, and the rest of the top 25 is Miami, Auburn, Kansas State, Oklahoma State, and Northern Illinois, which usually a team that's from the MAC gets one loss, and they're pretty much out of the top 25 for the rest of the year, but I guess Northern Illinois has like a little bit of a leeway. But this is our first conference game up here. We have a few recruiting points. We have 100 recruiting points to play with, so we're going to do exactly that. So let's see what we can do here to mess with our recruits a little bit. Visits. Let's see. We got a couple people that are ready to visit. The later on in the year they visit, the better we're off we are. And we get a complimentary visit as well if we do it at the right time. We got Aaron Hicks coming to one of to play for us. He's really interested. Because it'll give other teams that are interested in them a bad spot to possibly, you know, be out of the race for them. I've always seen that when I'm playing, you know, college football games. And these are all complimentary visits, so it's like, that always works out better for us, too. We have 19 scheduled visits. And we're gonna see what we can do for our wide receiver here. Our big target, that's 6'7". I want to scout him a little bit more because he's really been on my radar. He's got really good speed and carrying. Catching, it's decent. Spectacular catch in traffic and route running are really good for me. Catching in general is a big problem. It's only a 61. Speed, agility, stamina, strength, acceleration. They're all decent for a guy of his size. Not really expecting a whole lot. So now we're going to see who else we can target here. Let's look at our linebackers. Let's actually scout this guy a little bit more. Yeah, he hasn't changed a whole lot, so we're done recruiting for this week. I don't want to mess up any of the point systems that we have for any of our players, because I feel like we have, you know, just the right amount of every player that we need. So I will see you guys in the game, and I hope you guys enjoyed the little pregame as usual. And until then, peace.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both of these teams among the best passing offenses in the country, both ranked nationally in the passing game. There are weapons all over the field. But if anything, the secondaries ought to be used to it. I mean, they see a lot of this every day in practice. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
once again at UAB Stadium here taking on our first conference opponent in the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. And we are 1-2, looking to go back up to 2-2, try and stay even keel at about 500. If we could do that this season, I would be very, very happy. So on the kickoff, we have Cunningham taking this out to about the 24-yard line. Pretty good return to start off. Let's see how our offense has been working on it. You know, we got to improve on offense. Jason Johnson did do very good last week, considering he threw 6 touchdown passes, but he also did throw 3 interceptions. We can only hope that we can limit those turnovers and possibly come out with a win today. But with the way things have been going this season, with all the turnovers that we've been giving up, you know, it doesn't look like that's going to happen. Or at least the odds aren't in our favor to actually do that, where we actually have less than 2 turnovers. We have to have a clean game in order to win. That's pretty much how we're going to win these games. We got to keep the ball in our possession, keep a clean game, no turnovers whatsoever. So on the first few possessions, it is key to try and not give the ball away. We don't want to fall behind early like we did against LSU, and we don't want to, you know, give up some little tiny leads that we had last week against Washington State, and then they just took over once the turnover started happening. Anyway, third down and 14. Here's Jason Johnson deep down the middle, and there's our first turnover. It's Yates coming up with the pick, and exactly what I've been talking about is just turnovers. It's been killing us, and we got to do better protecting the football, keeping it in our possession. But because we haven't been doing that, and we've been trying, you know, the players aren't necessarily the best as far as overall goes and as far as skill sets and everything like that. But, I mean, look at the poor tackling right here. Our best player is like a 79 overall on defense, and he can barely tackle anybody. And he's a safety. Safeties are supposed to be hard hitters back there patrolling the secondary, and they haven't been doing that this whole year. And it's really kind of bad when they're breaking tackles like it's nothing. We're just trying to wrap up, and they're just breaking these tackles like it's nothing. So our defense needs to step up too, because we cannot rely on our defense for much. I mean, they don't last very long as far as, enduring the game. Like, they don't last very long. So we got to try and do better offensively if we want our defense to improve. So we make them settle for a field goal over here. Long field goal. The kick is up, but it hits the crossbar. It's no good, and UAB goes away without a defensive point given up, a defensive possession where they actually score. So that's actually a good thing. We're just hoping that we could just not give up a shit ton of points like we have been for the past couple of weeks. And it's just going to kill us if we keep on doing that. We got to have our offense perform. As you see right here, we get a touchdown here by Keith Brown, 24 yards out. And it's now 7-0 UAB. Good way to start off the game, I suppose, after having the turnover. We just hope that the turnovers don't become a trend. So Owens drops back. Look. Throws it. Oh, he was going to throw it deep, but he gets hit as he's throwing the ball, and UAB gets the ball back with a 7-point lead. Let's hope we can extend it to double digits or something, get a 2-touchdown lead early on. We get a pass over the middle to Irvin. He has some room to run down the field, down to the 10, down to about the 8-yard line for a pickup of 37 on the play. And now it's third down and goal. We have Marshall in motion. Here's Johnson looking to his fullback, and no. Minus 2 yards, negative 2. And he's hurt too, so that's even better. So we just lost our best fullback, but that's not really saying a whole lot because he's only a 49 overall. But we do settle for the field goal right there, so it's now 10-0 UAB. We have a solid lead going in to the end of the first quarter. That's a great way to start the game. What interception was that thrown? I mean, it doesn't look like that's much been done so far for the Louisiana Tech offense, but that right there kind of just nullifies all that with that 55-yard run by Eric Owens. And now the next play on first and 10, the start of the second quarter. They have their little wishbone going on. Here's Owens going deep to the end zone, and it's going to be caught by Jerry Gore for the touchdown. And it's now 10-7 as he got 1 foot in bounds. It's one in college, 2 in the pros. And first down, Keith Brown after that little 7-yard scamper. And we're just trying to extend our lead back up to 10 because I feel like 10 is a safe lead, but not too safe. Right now, this is not a safe lead for us. I guess no lead is safe for UAB, but hey, we're just trying to win it. We're just trying to take it one game at a time and just play every possession like it counts, like it's our last possession. So over the middle, Urban, first down UAB. Once again, our offense has been clicking. Jason Johnson is making a very strong case to remain the starting quarterback for the rest of the season. And if he does perform this game, I'm saying if he has like an above a positive touchdown to interception ratio, I mean, he may very well be the starter. I mean, he gives us a chance to, he gives us the best chance to win the game. And so far, I feel like me playing with him over Cutler is kind of what I might just go with. Look at Cutler's numbers. One touchdown to eight interceptions so far in his two games that he played against Iowa State and LSU. Yes, LSU is a tough opponent. And yes, Iowa State's not really that great, but he didn't do that great against Iowa State. Let's just throw that out there. Iowa State, we handled our business there in Ames, and we just gotta find a way. We just gotta find a way to make sure our offense fits perfectly. And Jason Johnson has been doing that so far. He's been making good throws. Yes, every time he throws an incomplete pass anymore, it seems to be intercepted. But hey, I mean, he's given us a chance to win the game. He's putting up points on the board. He's given our team a chance. He didn't give us much of a chance against LSU, but not like we didn't stand much of one anyway against LSU. But one touchdown, eight interceptions for Cutler. He six touchdowns to three interceptions to Jason Johnson. So I'm really leaning toward Jason Johnson right now. And as you should expect it too, I mean, you got to put the guys who are hot on the field, who are performing. You want the best out of your players, and Jason Johnson is definitely giving that to me right now. And yes, we are only up by three, and we just gotta play defense. But we're not gonna do that, are we? Nah. Look at all these broken tackles that Louisiana Tech's just shredding off like it's nothing. First and 10 for Louisiana Tech. Here's Owens, drops back, looking deep to the end zone. It's gonna be caught by Smith for the touchdown. Will Smith. Not the actor, not the Saints football player, but Louisiana Tech football player. So now it's 21-17. There goes our 10-point lead. And that's pretty much going to make their lead go bigger with that one. No, they're going to score pretty much. Our defense can't play right now. They've given up 21 points already in the second quarter after giving up none in the first. The defense is just falling apart. As you see, Owens just has all the time in the world. It's caught by Will Smith again, and he gets it in for the touchdown. It's now 28-17. Now they have a double-digit lead. Now the tables have turned, and now UAB is playing from behind as usual to try and, you know, pass first offense now, especially with the time limit that we have left. We only have like 8 seconds before we can try and score before half. But we do get it into field goal range for our kicker, Brown, and we're just trying to try one more play. We're trying to get a little bit closer for our kicker. Here's Jason Johnson looking over the middle again to Weiss and gets another first down. We call a timeout immediately with 1 second left, and we're going to send out Brown for the kick. It is right through the uprights. It's good. 28-20, so we're within strikeable distance going into half. You see the halftime stats. Time of possession, 8 minutes to 4 minutes. Rushing yards, 62-61. Pass yards, 263-226. The turnovers are killing us. They're killing us, man. They're killing us. We cannot have this. We cannot have it whatsoever. So, we got one more half to play. Let's see what we can do here. Second down and 7 for Louisiana Tech. They're changing the play. They like to run that no-huddle offense that I just really hate. And I can't make adjustments. I don't want to call timeouts, especially in the second half, because I want to save those in case my team has a chance to win the game. So, I kind of just have to put up with it. So second and inches, handoff to Morris, and he's going to get another first down. And I'm trying to switch up my schemes. You guys have said run more zone because your defense is not fast enough, and I understand that. So now that it's in conference play, maybe I can run a little bit more man because we're playing somewhat to our competition a little bit. But you see right there, Marlon Perez gets a gain of 12 on that catch and another Louisiana Tech Bulldog first down. Second and 10 here for the Louisiana Tech Bulldogs. Here's Owens dropping back. Gets hit as he throws, and it's off to Ross. And Ross sheds that tackle, sheds another one and another one before taking down after a gain of 15 yards. First and 10, Louisiana Tech. Again, Morris in motion. Here's Owens. Looks, has all the time in the world. Defense is not making any sort of threat to the quarterback right now. And it's now 35-20. That is bad. This is bad. Once again, UAB has fallen behind once again by double digits, by two touchdowns or more. And it's just not looking good for us right now. We just got to find something on offense that just gets us back in this. Even if we score, we're going to be down by, well, if we score, we're down by nine. But we need a two, I was going to try for a two-point conversion if we do score. And we do right here. So we do get the two-point conversion to not work. So it's now 35-26. So maybe I went for the two-point conversion early. Too early. Who knows? I thought, you know, maybe if I got it now, I wouldn't have to worry about it later. That was my logic behind it. But you see, Bates somehow did not come up with that interception and ends up being in Jerry Gore's hands for a pickup of 27. And that is just, that's just unlucky right there. It really is. So we're trying a third down and eight. We're trying some zone, and they get it underneath. So everything that we're trying to adjust for, they're just throwing something else at us, and it's just not really something I can deal with right now. My defense is just not skilled enough to try and stop this Louisiana Tech high-powered offense. So again, over to Bennett, down to about the two-yard line after a pickup of 15, and now it's second and goal for Louisiana Tech. Just a minute and 25 seconds left in the third, and they're trying to do a little run play. Oh, they're going to do a read option, and Bates cannot make the tackle. He makes him bounce off of him, and now it's 41-26 after they tried their own two-point conversion to make it a 17-point lead, but it's still a three-score lead nonetheless, or at least a two-score, at least two-point conversion at least for one of them. But we do throw another interception, so it's not really helping our case to make a comeback. So we're just falling apart right now. We're falling apart at the seams, and we're bleeding. We can't stop the bleeding at all. So Gore over the middle again picks up another first. We're still bleeding. We cannot stop the bleeding here in Birmingham, and it sucks. It really sucks. I mean, this is something that UAB is used to kind of in a way, but, you know, I'm trying to help this team turn around and trying to at least get them to a 500 record. So, 48-26, we're down by 22, and here's Marshall out to the right side, gets the first down again. Maybe we could get something going, maybe we can at least put up a fight, you know. I don't want this team to just fall down on his face like it has been for the past couple of weeks. But you see another catch here by Darrell Irvin, first down UAB. So now 4:40 left, we're going to try and run this little no-huddle stuff. So here's Jason Johnson again, over the middle to Lee Williams. He has been playing a huge factor into this offense, but he hasn't been making much noise today. But last game he had four touchdown receptions and he really came in huge. You see Brown with the catch and he gets another first down for UAB. We're within striking distance for once in the second half here in the fourth quarter, but it all falls apart right here. Jason Johnson, interception. That was a pretty lucky grab right there. I didn't see that linebacker there and I ended up paying the price. So hopefully we can make a stop. We can make a stop and try and get ourselves not get blown out by almost 30. That would be awful. I mean, just a 30-point blowout. We already had a 30-point blowout this year from LSU, a 42-10 loss. So another one to a conference opponent would just be even worse, in my opinion. I mean, it's understandable if you get blown out by 30 by LSU if you're a team like UAB, but to lose to a conference opponent like that by 30, it's just devastating. It really is. So we do make a stop on third down, and we do get the ball back. We finally made a stop in the second half for the first time since the first quarter. So Johnson again over to Weiss for a pickup of 37 on the play, and we're going to try and hurry up to the line here, try and get a quick score. Try and make this at least within a manageable deficit. So, again, here's Johnson. Gets the catch by Irvin, and Irvin scampers into the end zone for a 35-yard touchdown. It's now 48-32. So, at least it's somewhat manageable. It's not like a terrible. Well, it looks terrible right now, but on paper it looks at least somewhat decent. But you see, they just want to keep on running the ball. Kevin Morris, 27-yard touchdown. It's now 55-32, so they really want to just extend that lead a little bit, but I'm not having that. I'm not having that at all. So dumping it down to Zach Jones, and we do get the touchdown. We're going to go for two just because why not? And, you know, we've already lost this game. Why not just try and go for it? We do get the two-point conversion, making it 55-20, and that's how the game's going to end, ladies and gentlemen. We do fall to 1-3 on the season, so it's not really looking good for your UAB Blazers. But there's still plenty of season left. I have hope that we can at least make a bowl game and maybe even win it. Who knows? But if you guys did enjoy, please make sure to leave a like. Also, If you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe. I will try and get out as many videos as I can. I'm trying to push to at least 3 times a week, one series each week, or one video of each series a week, and hopefully that's somewhat manageable in my schedule because it's pretty hectic. But until next time, my name is Sin with Vengeance, and I am out of here. Peace.